So one of the cool things about RVing is all the new friends we make. Yep. However, it's really important that we keep up with all our old friends too. And today, we're hanging out with Debbie and Jerry, who we've been friends with since I was about 17 years old. So we go way, way, way back.
Way, way, way back.
Okay, watch your mouth. Now, today, we are taking our very first ever Jeep ride. And I'm super excited because I've never done this before. And Danny, do you think this is going to make us want a Jeep?
Maybe.
We'll see. Let's get traveling down the road.
Let's go.
Did you ever not know? You were never out there alone. Do you think there's a chance for this love to be real?
Yeehaw! Man, I love this. Are we there yet?
No,
oh,
not
5 minutes.
We're still on pavement. There's lots of fishes in here. They're babies. Where there's babies, there's mamas.
Fill me with a desire that I cannot break. Did you ever let go? Did you ever not know? You were never out there.
We're on the top of the world!
So we've drove to the other side of Glacier National Park for two reasons. The first reason is that if you stay on the east side, there are no grocery stores, and I wouldn't say zero, but there is a one that we consider higher than convenience store prices. So
yeah, it's the only thing there on the east side out the east gate, so you really don't want to do grocery shopping at that store.
A small box of Cheerios was $12.
Yeah.
So.
And I mean, it was a small box of Cheerios.
Hands on the wheel.
Yeah, okay.
And the second reason is we're meeting friends.
So there are times when you're visiting Glacier National Park that you just got to get out and get into a town where you feel like you're a little bit more in civilization. And today we're doing that. We're hanging out in Whitefish, but there are lots of small towns around with cool little city streets like this one.
And while we're in Whitefish, we're going to meet up with our friends, the Roadsmiths. I'll make sure I put a link to their YouTube channel down below, so make sure you check that out. And we won't be doing video or interviewing or anything. We're just going to have lunch and get to know each other a little bit better and finish looking around Whitefish.
Today's the day. RV America is headed to Canada.
Not that we've seen everything in the U.S., but we are
by
so
no shot.
But we are so close to Waterton Lake National Park of Canada. It's about an hour away from Glacier, so we're heading up there and to see if we can have just a day trip, just to see a few things.
Just explore a little bit. We'll maybe go have tea and what is it we're going to have?
Crumpets.
Tea and crumpets.
Yeah, I got to practice holding my pinky.
At the Albertan Hotel? I'm really
Prince of Wales. Prince of Wales Hotel.
The Prince of Wales Hotel.
Yep.
So it'll be fun. Let's go.
So we've just left St. Mary's and got an hour drive. We'll see you there.
Raise me. I need something fast.
We didn't realize it, but apparently we go through Glacier National Park to get to the border, because there was just a sign back there, from where we're at least.
Well, help me interrogate her. How big is your love? Tell me how high is your patience? Can I be safe?
We drive all the way from Tennessee. We are now in Canada. And guess who we run into? People from Tennessee. Knoxville, come on.
Knoxville.
As soon as we get across the border, this is the first people we meet is our fellow Tennesseans. It's awesome.
Tennesseans have equally good taste.
They do have equally good taste.
Hey, all this fake news, tell me.
Inside the park here at Waterton Lakes National Park is a cute little village and tons of restaurants, and we got lucky and picked out a great one, Thirsty Bear, and had bison fajitas, and she had a
smash burger
with the Alberta beef.
Yeah,
so
really good.
They did a great job. Thing you want to do is take the short hike to Cameron Falls. You see it from a distance, but it's pretty falls, and now we're heading to Cameron Lake.
Now how big is your love? Tell me how high is your patience? Can I be saved? I want to catch the wave. Hold on, he will break.
So we made a stop off at the Prince of Wales Hotel, and let me tell you, no matter which way you which side of the building you get a room on, you are going to have an amazing view. It's just built in the middle of this little, is it a valley?
In the hill. In the valley.
And it's completely surrounded by mountains.
And the Waterton Lakes.
And the Waterton Lakes. So it's just gorgeous. We went in and we were going to have tea and...
Tea and crumpets.
We wanted to have tea and crumpets. But we got in there. We'd already had lunch. And we got in there and just happened to see a price list. And the price for tea and crumpets was $49 a person.
Well, it was a tea, and I think you had four courses to the tea.
Yeah, we didn't want that. So we just found another little coffee shop in the hotel and had coffee sitting in the front lobby.
For $4.
Yeah, for $4 a piece. That was much more our style. Yes. So, but anyway.
So you can join either way. You can get the full-on British tea, afternoon tea for $49, or you can go to the little coffee shop and get
you can do it the cheap Danish way, the way we did. We didn't even want Danish.
Or whatever. We didn't get one, but.
Yeah. Now, we're going back down to the little village, and we're going to have ice cream. That's more our style. So if you enjoyed this video of things to do around Glacier National Park, be sure you click on the link that Danny's going to put in here of all the things there are to do inside Glacier National Park. It's our favorite national park. Until next time, God bless and many safe travels.
And go RV, America.